Hey, what's up you guys? My name is Juan, and today I'd like to show you guys how to simplify radical expressions. Okay, let's get started. So the simplified form for square root of 8 is equal to 2 times the square root of 2. So there's one thing that we have to keep in mind when we're solving this type of questions. So we all have to know the property of radicals that says the square root of a times b is equal to the square root of a times the square root of b. So in this example, we know that 8 is going to be equal to 4 times 2. And we know that it can be written as the square root of 4 times the square root of 2. The square root of 4 is 2. And the square root of 2, we can't simplify it, so we end up with the square root of 2, which is this, what we're going to try to demonstrate. So it's pretty easy. There's two steps that you have to follow in order to simplify radical expressions. Step 1, factor. So we're going to factor the number that is inside the radical in prime factors, numbers that are prime. I'm going to start with the 8 here and the line. So here are going to be my factors, and here is going to be the division of that number by the factors. I like to start with the smallest one, so for example, 2 and 3 and so on. So I'm going to start with 2. When we divide 4 by 2, it's going to be, we end up with a 4. Then we divide it by 2 again, we end up with 2, then 2, and then a 1 here. So if we multiply the factors, we're going to end up with this number. So it's important that you do it all the way until you get 1 here. So these factors multiplied are going to give you this number. Second step, group. So since this is a squared root, we need to have factors that are squared. So when we have factors that are the same, that go by couples here in this example, we can take them out of the radical. As you can see, I like to cross them out. So this 2, it could give me a 2. There's going to be 3. These are my free numbers. So these are going to be my free numbers that are going to be outside the radical. And these are going to be my numbers that are going to still be inside the radical. So as you can see, this 2 is the 2 that is in front of the radical. And this 2 that is still inside the radical is still inside. So now we have another example. It's the cubic root of 162. So okay, first step, it's again factor. So we have 162. We can divide it by 2 because this, the last number is even. It's 8, 1. When we add up these two numbers, it's 9. Which is a multiple of 3, so we can divide it by 3. So 3. 7, can divide it by 3, it's 9, divided by 3, it's 3, and divided by 3 again, it's 1. So we end up with a 1. So when we multiply all these numbers together, we're going to end up with 162. Now, we're not working with couples again, because we're taking the cubic root. So instead of taking couples, we're going to take triples, and so on. So if you don't have a cubic root, instead you have like a root 4 or a root 5 and so on, you want to look for 4 and 5 numbers that are the same. In this example, we're looking for 3 triples. So we have a triple here of 3s, so we cross them out, and from all of them, we end up with a single 3. And we don't have another triple of 2s, and we don't have another triple of 3s. So this is going to be our free number. So this is equal to our free number, which is 3, times the multiplication of all these factors together. So 2 times 3, it's 6. And that's our final answer. So I hope you guys liked this video, and if you did, please give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment down below. And if you liked it a lot, please just click the subscribe button right here. Bye.